So next result is, if G is non-abelian group of order P raised to power 3, P is prime number. So determine the order of center of G and number of conjugate classes of G which is equal to K. So what is the proof of this theorem? Now what is P? P is prime number. So order of G which is equal to P raised to power 3. So in the previous question, so we proved that order of center of G is equal to P. So in the previous question also it is raised to power, so it implies by previous result order of center of G which is equal to P. So what is P? P is a prime number. So remember that. Now it means this G is not equal to center of G because it has order P cube, it has P order. So it implies G is not equal to center of G. Center of G is subgroup of G, but they are not equal. If they are not equal, so there exists some element which belongs to G, but it does not belongs to center of G. So it implies there exists some element A which belongs to G, but A does not belongs to center of G. Why? Because it is a proper subgroup of a group G. So remember that there exists some element which satisfy this conditions. Now I take some B element belongs to center of G. So by definition of center of G, it implies Bx is equal to Xb for every x belongs to G. So it means it commutes with every element of G. If it commutes with every element of G, so it means Bx is equal to Xb. So it implies in particular A belongs to G, this A belongs to G, in particular BA is equal to AB. So in particular A I am taking as X, the X is equal to A. So BA is equal to AB. So what it means? It means B belongs to normalizer of A. So center of G is part of normalizer of A. So what it means? Center of G, which is subset of normalizer of A. And what is normalizer of A? Because it is a subgroup of group G. So this is a subset of G. So this values. Now here, since we know that A belongs to normalizer of A, then and A does not belongs to center of G. So it means this is not equal to normalizer of A. If not equal to normalizer of A, then center of G, which is a proper subset of normalizer of A and which is a subgroup of group G, this values. Now by using the Lagrangian theorem, so order of normalizer of is divide order of G. Also from this, order of normalizer of A which is greater than order of center of G. So what is its value? Which is equal to P. Also by Lagrangian theorem, order of normalizer of A which divide order of G, so which is equal to P raised to power 3. So from this values, so this order is greater than P, and divide this, so it has only two options. Either it is P square or it is a P raised to power 3. So it has only two choices. Either it is P square or it is a P cube. So first I take, if I take order of normalizer of A which is equal to P cube, then what it means? It means G is equal to NA, then it means NA is equal to G. So by using the remarks, it means A belongs to center of G, but which is impossible because A does not belongs to center of G. So which is contradiction. So which is contradiction. If it is a contradiction, then order of normalizer of A is equal to P square. So remember that it is equal to P square because it contradicts at this value. So order of normalizer of this is equal to P square. Now, to find the index of NA in G, so what is order of G over order of normalizer of A? So this is equal to P cube over P square. So what its value? So this is a prime number. So this is a prime number P. For every A does not belongs to center of G, and order of center of G is equal to P. So for every A does not belongs to center of G, and order of center of G which is equal to P, that we know that. So this values. Now if A belongs to center of G, so we know that if A belongs to center of G, then it implies class of A consisting only one element, which element is A itself. So it implies order of class of A, this is equal to 1 when A belongs to center of G. If A does not belongs to center of G, so in that case class of A, so in that case class of A which is equal to order of class of A which is equal to order of G over order of normalizer of A, so which is equal to P. So this value is a prime number which is equal to P. Now every conjugate class has length, has number of element either 1 or P. It means if A belongs to center of G, then it has one element. If A does not belongs to center of G, then it has P elements. So every class has two options, either it has one element or it has P element. Right, so suppose those which has one element, so that will equal to order of center of G, right? The classes, so it implies every class, every class have either one or p elements, either one or p elements, either it has one element or it has p elements. Now suppose the number of classes are k, that is given. So it means number of classes are k, then it means ki if order of center of G is p, so it implies order of G which is equal to this values, order of center of G, this is by class equation, plus summation of this value, order of G over order of normalizer of A, this values. So this is, its order is P. It means P classes have one element and the remaining classes are K minus P. So here A does not belongs to center of G. Here it does not belongs to center of G. So it means order of center of G. So this is equal to values P. This value is P. So remaining classes are K minus P. So K minus P classes have P elements. So plus this value is equal to K minus P into P. This values. What is its order? Its order is P cube. So P cube is equal to this values, which is P plus K minus P into P. So this can be written as, so P is divided, so this can be written as P plus K P minus P square. So it means this K can be written as P square plus P minus 1. P square plus P minus 1. So that is the number of classes, conjugate classes of this group whose order is equal to P raised to power 3. So I repeat once again. Now the total number of classes are, total number of classes in our question are K, right? So P classes have order 1. Because its order is P. So P classes have order 1 and remaining classes are K minus P. So it has order, it has element P. So it multiply by P, K minus P into P. This is P into 1. So this value will become P into 1 plus K minus P into P. So that is my result. So this type is very important. Now after that, the next statement is, the next result is normalizer of a subgroup H. So first, what is, these are the simple result, let H be a subgroup, H be a subgroup of group G, subgroup of a group G. So this is a subgroup of a group G. Now if it is a subgroup of group G, so let define normalizer of H. So this is a normalizer of H. It consisting all x belongs to G such that hx is equal to xh. So it means the right coset, all element which make no distinction between right coset and left coset. So this is called a normalizer. Normalizer of H in G. So this is a normalizer of H in G. Now my aim is to prove that result number one, कि normalizer of H is a largest subgroup of G in which H is normal. Result number one, normalizer of H is largest subgroup of G in which H is normal, in which H is normal. So we have two questions, even three. One is it is a subgroup, second is largest subgroup, and third is in which H is a normal. So it is my first part. So first I prove the first part, then we will discuss the second part. Now normalizer of H. So this is a normalizer of H. So which consisting all element X belongs to G such that Hx is equal to Xh. Now to prove the subgroup, first prove that it is a non-identity. Now as we know that E belongs to H. Why? Because H is a subgroup and subgroup contain a identity. So it implies HE is equal to EH. So since this condition is satisfied, so if and only if, since HE is equal to EH, it implies E belongs to normalizer of H. So it implies normalizer of H is non-empty. So this is my first part. Now second part, to prove the subgroup. So I take two element, one is X, second is Y, belongs to normalizer of H. So it implies by definition, so this will become Hx is equal to Xh, and Hy is equal to Yh. So this result can be written as Hy inverse, Y inverse H is equal to Y inverse H. You may see that this result can be written in this way. Now to prove XY inverse belongs to normalizer of H, so it means that element commute with XY inverse. So I take H, then XY inverse. So it means HX. So this is HX can be written as XH. So this is XH into Y inverse. So by using this product. Now what it means? It means X HY inverse. By using this result, this will become XY inverse H. So what it becomes? It becomes XY inverse into H. So this element commute with H. If this element commute with H, so it implies XY inverse belongs to normalizer of H. So what it means? It means normalizer of H, which is a subgroup of group G group G. This is a subgroup of group G. Now next is, it is a largest subgroup of G in which H is normal. First I prove H is normal in G, and then prove that it is a largest subgroup of group G in which H is normal. Now next is to prove that H is normal in this set. Now since we know that for every H belongs to capital H, what it means? H into small h, which is equal to small h into capital H. What it means? It means H belongs to normalizer of H. For every H belongs to capital H. So what it means? It means H is subset of normalizer of H. So this is a contained in normalizer of H. Now to prove that it is a normal. Normal means if it satisfy the property of normal of H, right? Now for every H is normal in this, it means it satisfy for every X belongs to, as we know the by definition, if I belongs to X, belongs to normalizer of H, then by definition it will become HX is equal to XH, right? So what it means? It means this element is of this group and this is a H. So H is normal in normalizer of H. So this is a normal subgroup of normalizer of H. Now next is to prove that it is a largest, this is a larger subgroup of G in which H is normal. So in which H is normal. So it is a larger subgroup of G in which H is a normal. Now let K is some normal subgroup of group G of group G in which H is normal. In which H is normal. So I take another subgroup of group G in which H is normal. So to prove N of H is largest, so my simple claim is if K is a part of normalizer of H, then it means it is a largest group. To prove it is a largest group, so my claim is K is subset of normalizer of H. Now H is normal in K, so that is a given. H is normal in K and K is part of normalizer of H. So I take this value, suppose I take some K belongs to capital K from this set. What it means? H is normal in K. It means H commute with every element of K. So it implies H into small K, which is equal to small K into H. Why? Because since H is normal in K, so it is a normal in K, So it means HK is equal to KH. If HK is equal to KH, it means K commute with H. So K belongs to normalizer of H. So it implies this K is a part of normalizer of H. So which prove our result. So it means N of H is a largest subgroup in which H is normal. So that is my result. Now second part. So what is the statement of second part? If H is subgroup of group G, H is normal in G, if and only if normalizer of H is equal to G. So this values, H is normal in G, if and only if normalizer of H is equal to G. So it is a if and only if part. So first part, let H is normal in G. So first part in this color, in blue color. So H is normal in G. It means H commute with every member of G. So what it means? It means HX is equal to XH for every X belongs to G. This values. What it means? It means X belongs to normalizer of H for every X belongs to G. So what it means? G is a subset of normalizer of H. G is a subset of normalizer of H. Also, normalizer of H is a subgroup of G. So it implies G is equal to normalizer of H. It proves our first part. Now second part, this is given. Now to prove that H is normal in G. So from this, let X is some element belongs to G. What is G? G is equal to normalizer of H. So by definition, what we get? HX is equal to XH. What is X? For every X belongs to G. So what it means? It means H is normal subgroup of group G. So H is normal subgroup of group G. So which prove our result. So this is very important result, in which the relation between normalizer of H and this values, right? So this is very important result.